Hey, people. How's it going out there in internet land? Wherever you might be joining us this fine evening or morning or wherever you are, maybe you're sitting over a bowl of cereal right now listening to our podcast.
I hope it's Captain Crunch.
Or, you know, maybe you're watching live, which, you know, that's more fun because you can interact. You can get in the chat room and talk to us.
Maybe we'll talk back this time.
Yeah, maybe we won't ignore you.
Yeah, we're new on this Twitch thing.
Yeah, so join us. You know, we had a person in our chat last week that asked a question. It was like, episode 305. How are you guys there already? You have a website and all. You know, he was very baffled by this because we had like
I think you're
four.
New.
We had four followers on Twitch, and supposedly we had 305 episodes. To clarify, that's season 3, episode 5. Tonight is season 3, episode 6. We kind of, you know, we don't keep these going straight through a period like over and over. We kind of take a break here and there, and
hiatus,
then,
if you will.
This last one was a long one, but yeah, so if you're questioning the 305, season 3, episode 5,
we like TV. If you're a true fan, you'll mm-hmm. know where they're at on the interwebs.
Yeah,
you'll
yeah.
find the other
we have
season.
A website, minintub.com. You can check it out. You can look at things there, mainly podcasts.
You can talk back at us.
We need to work on that. Get some more content on there.
You can send us emails at iwantogit@meninatub.com. Yeah, we want to be interactive. We want to be with you and you with us and things making magic on the internet. This is how it works. But, you know, it's a thrilling time to be here again. I'm excited. How you doing, Kyle?
I'm doing great.
Okay,
I'm,
that's good.
I mean, I've got a cold, but
I noticed
I'm
you had a bit of
here.
A cold, little sniffles.
Yeah, a little of the sniffles.
Sniffy snippies.
Yeah, but I'm
try,
here.
Try to
I'm
keep
powering
snot
through it.
Off the mic, if you could.
I'll try to keep right. the snot off of there, and I'll try to keep it off of you guys' arms and stuff, too.
Yeah, I don't want to catch a cold.
Appreciate it.
And then, Jeremy, how you doing? Doing okay?
You know, I'm doing all right. Busy week at work, so a little groggy, tired. But
okay.
you know,
well, I'm glad you're gonna
paycheck.
I'm glad you're gonna
you know?
Bring the life to the party.
That's what I'm doing.
I'm glad that you're yeah. here with some energy and you're enthused. That's great. Trevor, how's it going?
It's going quite well now. I am in the final process of buying that house.
Sweet.
And I should be moving in next week. So.
Sweet. That's a nice thing.
House party.
You mean to tell me this is a process? It doesn't just happen instantaneously.
Well, I got to get the genie to come along and wish it, you know.
Genies, well, never there when you need them.
Yeah, they are kind of elusive, you know.
I've been raging against travel.
I've rubbed many a lamp.
As have I.
Never a genie, never genie, never. Always the groom, never the genie.
Wow.
I don't know. I'm not sure that's the same. so, yeah, that's not a real saying.
It's not.
No. I think it is, though.
It is now.
We
it
made
is
it
now.
One. We made it one. It's great. Use it. Ladies, so what do you think happening? Anything exciting happening, like other than work and boring things? And Nathan, you're raising your hand like this is school. So
yeah,
I raise my hand in a lot of contexts.
Your turn.
That is
okay.
Probably true.
You may talk now. You've been talking.
Hey, Nathan, special
selected.
Guest. Good job.
What's going on?
So Thursday. So actually, the day after our last podcast, I came home after work. So this was maybe 11 o'clock at night,
mm-hmm.
and I come in my door, and for the many of you who haven't been in my apartment, my door opens.
that means all of you on the internet.
Most people, yes. I've never been in your apartment.
I don't think yes. I have either.
I think Trevor's the only person okay, here who probably. Has.
I've yeah. been near the door.
Okay. Anyways.
The door opens up into the kitchenette, and the oven is the first thing you see. So I walk in, I walk past the oven, and suddenly I turn and I realize there's something on top of the oven.
Okay.
Was it a burglar?
No, it was a TV.
Raccoon.
A TV?
Wait, a TV?
What? There was just this TV sitting atop my stove.
For no, was it your TV?
It is now.
How did it get there?
I'm not done.
All right. Continue.
So I go to turn on the light to better assess the situation.
And your house explodes because someone left the gas on.
No.
Oh, okay, sorry.
No, there was a DVD-VCR combo in my recliner.
Yes!
You got reverse burgled.
I got it reverse burgled. Burgled.
That's weird. Was someone high and thought that was like
from 1998 is when it came from though.
Was it a tube TV, like a older like CRT, like big TV, or was it like a flat panel, or was it?
I think it was made in the 90s.
Okay, yeah, there you go.
So it's a big, heavy one.
Yeah.
So do you have any idea who it was?
Yes, I eventually figured it out.
Okay.
Couple of guys that I knew from an old job, specifically a camp job, they stopped by my work, but I was so busy that we never had time to exchange words. Mm-hmm. And come to find out, they had shown up because they wanted to give me this TV, and they just happened to know where I kept my spare key.
That's kind of creepy.
Yeah, that's awkward.
Did they actually know, or did they just assume and like find it? Like, oh, it's under like, the pot, under the rock.
So where do you keep your spare key?
Yeah, let's let the internet know.
In the spare place.
Oh, great.
And also your address.
The spare place.
That's 111 South Spare Place. All right. Yeah. I mean, if someone's going to break in your house and do something, it's better that they gift you. Then they rob you.
So I actually have three TVs now. I don't even know where to put this new one.
You should just line them all up.
On the curb.
It wasn't that you had a need that they thought to give it to you. Were they just trying to get rid of it?
I guess.
Nathan has like all these movie quotes in his head. I bet he likes TVs.
Like at one point I had said to him, oh, maybe I should just get a second TV. Because back at the time I only had one.
Mm-hmm. Which is a valid thought.
And that was like 2 years ago.
Question, will you try to watch and live tweet more than one movie at the same time now?
Yes, please
you
do.
You should try that.
Oh, God, I don't know if I could.
Here's what you do. Three TVs, right? So pick a trilogy. Mm-hmm. Okay?
I'm intrigued.
Start all three movies at the same time.
Okay.
And try to live tweet all three of them at once. See what happens.
I'd probably lose track of which hashtag I was using and things would get jumbled.
Well, you just hashtag. Create one.
Yeah, it's...
Like Star Wars Trilogy.
Star Wars Trilogy.
Oh, okay, that could work.
Yeah.
BTTF Trilogy.
I think this is...
Back to the Fort.
This is cool.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we have an idea now.
Okay, well, that's good. You should do that. We'll live tweet it. It'll be great.
There you go.
You will be...
NathanSmith30 is his Twitter handle if you want to follow along.
Say hi.
Follow Nathan.
If you want to learn anything about any movie from the last four decades,
he might know.
Definitely follow him. And and late at night, you'll get tweets about movies.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, at some point, I'll do Wizard of Oz. That's older than the last four decades.
Well, there you go.
You could live tweet
unless
like
it's a new one. Always.
Different versions of the Wizard of Oz.
Ooh.
That's another idea. You could watch three different versions.
Yeah, now that we're in the era of remakes, you could.
Yeah. Like Fantastic Four.
Oh, don't make me do that.
But you got to wait till the new one comes out on DVD.
You'd have one I'm sure you could, at least that was decent.
Yeah, I'm sure you could pirate that one for, and no one would care.
Yeah.
No, not even the studio.
They would care.
Someone just happy. Watch it, please.
We don't care.
Has anybody seen that movie?
Nope.
No.
You're all probably better for it. I haven't seen it.
I followed your method of madness with the, what is that? The
Rotten Tomatoes.
Rotten Tomatoes. That's the one I was trying to think of.
You know, I get a lot of criticism for that, but I just about said something really pretentious. When you don't have much time and you have to utilize your time because time is money. No, that's what I felt like I was leaning towards that way. But
I use a different method. My method is the how many men in a tub like the movie.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's, you know, three or more, it's worthy to go see in the theaters.
Like I've gotten so bad now that if it's not certified fresh, like it hasn't gotten enough reviews to be certified, I kind of am like, I don't know if I should go see this because maybe I'll just wait for DVD.
It makes sense in your situation because then you got to pay for a babysitter and all that jazz.
It's like $1,000. Not really, but
it probably feels like it.
If I like a movie, I look the look of a movie, I'll go watch it. I don't have to worry about babysitters.
Yeah, but then when you see the movie and it sucks, then, well, good thing you wasted that time.
Well, I don't like movies that suck, so...
But how do you know that you...
There you go.
You've never been to a bad movie?
Trevor has an intuitive sense of what does and does not suck.
My name's Trevor, and I do not like movies that suck.
I think that your argument is with Rotten Tomatoes, though, is
this sounds like a great. This is fantastic. We're going off the
script.
Where are we
going
with this? Here.
Oh yeah,
Trevor, tell me a great movie. That you've seen recently without looking at the reviews. Come on.
I'm trying to think of what I've seen recently.
Spit it out.
Just anything, really.
Okay, in the last
Ant-Man.
5 years.
Ant-Man was really
good.
Okay, Ant-Man. No, come on.
What? Ant-Man was great.
Ant-Man.
Ant-Man was really good.
Ant-Man was like probably my favorite Marvel movie.
79% certified fresh.
Certified fresh, though.
So it's his favorite Marvel movie.
Eric wants to see this.
I watched a movie.
Certified fresh. I'd like to see this movie.
I watched a movie a couple of nights ago that had alien cats in it.
Okay, Trevor, tell me another movie.
No one likes Toy Story.
Was it The Cat from Outer Space?
No.
I don't know.
Some movie you saw the trailer and you just went because of the trailer.
I saw the trailer and just went. There's not a whole lot of those.
You just said that you go to movies and you just know that they're going to be good. So give me one example other than Ant-Man.
Well, I really want to go see the Man from U.N.C.L.E.
Man. Okay, we have something to work with there.
From you want to go see it? Let's see if you should see it, or do you not want us to tell you?
I don't care. It won't determine what I do. So
it should. Wait.
So
the
what
internet
will determine
broke
what you do? That. Fate.
Uh oh.
What? Yeah.
Uh oh.
I think it's working now, man. There we go. Well, no. Oh! Agent 47, by the way, is
holy
getting 5%.
Cow.
So
wow.
Go see that.
Jeez. Oh man, that's
disgusting. Ouch.
That might be worse than the Fantastic Four.
That is. Fantastic Four has 9%.
No, I was like, was it? Where is it at now?
It was at 4%.
I thought that was
6%. It's at eight right now.
Okay.
8%.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there you go.
A Man from U.N.C.L.E. is 66%. So yeah, that would have been pretty good. All right,
what's another movie, Trevor?
Do you got anything else? Nothing else?
I don't know.
We need three to like prove your theory at least that you can pick them.
You went and saw Pixels, didn't you?
Heck no.
Did you go
see? I'm not a moron.
Cool. What's the last movie you've seen then, other than Ant-Man?
The last movie I saw.
You saw Ant-Man and what did you
see? In theaters or not? Just
whatever. No, it's got to be in theaters because we're talking about going to a movie theater. This is the
criteria. Well, but the movie theater seems to be taking a long time for him to think of, so I was just trying to give him any
movie. Don't remember the movie you saw before Ant-Man.
I'm trying to think. I don't
know. Was it Terminator?
No.
Was it Inside Out?
I think it was Inside Out, yeah.
No, that got a 98%. Whatever, this game sucks. Let's move on.
You proved me right.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
You're a movie trailer savant. All right. Anything else going on with anybody else in life in general?
I had some rotten luck on Monday.
Rotten
tomatoes?
Luck.
Rotten luck.
Is that like when your luck goes bad?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, sour. It was bad.
All right.
So I there's this place that I like to go
to eat.
Eat. Does luck go bad or do you just not have it?
It expires.
It's probably both.
Or you run out? Maybe
you can't ever run out of luck. If there's good luck and there's bad luck, you can't not have it. You just have luck that you don't like.
Thank you. I agree.
So you always have luck. Just good or bad.
It's just good or bad. All so right. Anyway, I went to go to this place. It's called Brewski's. They used to have, I'm getting ahead of myself. So we went because they have cheap tacos on Monday nights, 59-cent tacos. They're not anything special.
That sounds like they're made out of dog food, probably. How can they afford to charge such?
They actually go out back and
it's
go
probably
over.
They make their money off the alcohol sales. I suppose.
Okay. Yeah,
they go out back and they pick them up from Taco John's.
Dog food,
probably.
And then they just bring
them
in.
That would be Taco Bell, though. That's the dog food, not Taco John's, right?
Yeah, they're both dog food.
Whatever.
Yeah.
That's probably not true
at
all.
You need to learn to like tacos.
I love tacos.
Maybe I'll have the most expensive taco.
Anyway, try the most expensive taco. It'll be worth your dollars.
Look it up on YouTube.
Anyway, so we went in, we walked in, and they didn't have it anymore. They changed their special. So instead of being on Monday nights that they've got taco night, now it's on Tuesday nights.
Well, logically, so it's Taco Tuesday. That
Taco
makes sense.
But here's the deal. What happens to the people that want tacos on Monday?
You pay regular price.
It's so original that it's Taco Tuesday now. And they upped their charge. It's now $1 per taco.
They got better me.
It's mostly because
they're like,
kids
you can have soft tacos and hard tacos and whatever kind, different tortillas. And I'm like, I just wanted my cheap tacos. So instead of spending like $5 for a meal of 10 tacos, I ended up with like $10 for a sandwich, and I just was not satisfied.
Your life is ruined.
I'm sorry.
It was ruined.
Jeremy, hug Kyle.
No.
Yeah, give him a hug because he doesn't get 59-cent tacos anymore.
That is depressing.
Give him a big hug.
59-cent tacos are a big deal.
You're going to catch his cold now.
Yeah.
So, Jeremy, you watched a movie about space cats?
Yeah, I can't even remember the name of it, but it was like from like 1986 or something. No.
No. Okay, you tell us about it. I'm going to look and see if I can find it.
It was, so there's this young fighter pilot and his buddy, best friends.
Luke Skywalker.
Kind of like Top Gun starting off, right? Because the one kid had blonde hair, like bleach blonde. Anyway, and he's special. He can calculate things.
Is it the cat from outer space? 1978.
See, that's what I said.
Not that old.
Okay, keep going.
I'm thinking it's sometime mid-90s, maybe.
I thought you said 80s.
Maybe late 80s, 88 to 94. Maybe it's in that range. Anyway, you don't even see the alien cats until about 2/3 of the way through the movie. Okay. You don't even know there are alien cats. So it's kind of like this, you know there's aliens. You know there's these aliens. They're fighting these aliens, but you don't know what they are. And then all of a sudden, bam, on the screen, there's this alien cat. And you're like, what? I thought it was funny.
Wait, so that's the whole thing?
That was Mr. It had was alien it animated? Cats in it. There's a lot of movies about alien cats, so look it up. There is a lot.
Now, when you say alien cats, were they like house cats that just came from space? No. Or were they more like...
They were like people aliens with cat faces. Like angry cat. So like,
so it was like watching BoJack Horseman.
Yeah.
Like human bodies and cat heads.
Just like that. Exactly the same.
I'm sure.
I was going to run that through Larry Niven, but sure. BoJack
Horseman. Was it Jonesy? No. Is that's anybody not keeping it. Up with that him? Was a cat from the Alien series.
I don't know.
Anyway,
I don't see that.
It was
movie.
Weird. It was. Sure it was on Amazon. It was on Amazon Prime. And
are you sure you actually watched this movie?
I'm fairly sure. Fairly sure I watched it.
Maybe it was a dream. Maybe you were dreaming. Yeah. Like, because remember when you dreamt about the computers? Now you're dreaming about alien cats,
space cats.
It's the next logical conclusion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that must be what it is. Sorry, guys. Just another dream that I was in, or something.
Okay.
So, yeah, there was
wait,
that.
Wait.
What?
No.
It was just
give
a t-shirt.
It up. Give up the dream, just Kyle. You're not going to find it. The internet is broken. There's no more space cats.
You suck.
Did you apply that to
you
yourself?
You know, so, but instead
I applied
of,
that to the alien cats all around.
They do suck.
I mean, I don't like cats, so I get the whole fighting alien cats thing.
Because if they're from outer space, we should kill them.
Cats are mean. Like, in general.
You've not met my cat.
Right, Trevor.
You obviously haven't talked to your roommates about your cat.
Yeah, because they're like, that cat's a jerk.
he's nice proof. To me.
He's nice to you. Is that,
you feed
that's,
him.
That's why he's nice to me.
Yeah,
he's mean to them, I mean.
Because they don't feed him?
I tell him to be mean.
I don't think a cat would do anything anyone tells it to do. Cats are very independent.
That's a scientific that fact.
Yeah.
All right, Jeremy, so you couldn't figure out what your movie was. You got anything else for us?
Well, so there is something that's going on right now that I think everyone should be concerned about.
Your voice got kind of serious.
Is it this Kyle's cold?
This is, it's
everyone
not,
should be concerned about catching my cold.
It's not alien cats trying to blow up the Earth, but it is something maybe closer to our time.
Okay, what's that?
Artificial intelligence.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
Listen. That's right. Killer robots, people.
What are you getting at?
They're coming. Killer robots are coming.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
If Eric was keeping up, he would see that I have a link for him.
Yeah, I know.
Of killer robots.
Just, hey, I'm it's all right.
You don't have to get all meta on me.
You know how Facebook with their plane. There's some themes happening here. Facebook with their flying plane. But no, Google. Google's at the top of this. Or is it Alphabet? We shall find out. Anyway, there's this guy, 41-year-old man.
Dramatic buildup.
Who, I think he's a, what is he, a dentist? I think he's a dentist.
Your mom's a dentist.
Anyway, you see the Pledge Allegiance, right? Pull that up there. Pledge Allegiance to Killer Robots. This is important. So, Stephen Hawking, Bill Gates.
Elon Musk.
Elon Musk.
Wait, we already knew this, didn't we? We talked about this a couple weeks ago.
No.
all these guys that got.
We talked about these guys.
I think he's talking about the new guy in the story.
There's a new guy in the story.
Oh,
but,
okay.
But it does have Google's robot running through the forest, which looks pretty creepy. So maybe you can find that. But basically, there's this new website. So
called Google's
kind of a public alert kind of thing here. and so what they're thinking is before the AI gets to the point where they are going to become killer robots, because of course humanity is the greatest virus, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're saying, hey, killer robots, they're going to be on the internet. They're going to find us. So what we should do is pledge allegiance to them in order to save our lives. So you can go to their website.
Is that a
sign
wait,
up?
Hang on. Is that a goat with like a hand?
I think
for
it was.
Its head?
Yeah, I think it was.
It's like that one character from Mario 2.
But basically, okay. if you're concerned about these killer robots, like everyone else should be, Stephen Hawking is. I mean, he's almost a killer robot, but. that was a bad joke.
So mean.
That was really mean. Anyway, you can go there. Thank you, Kyle. You can go to the website. You can sign up. Like a week ago, there was like 20 people. Maybe we can see how many people are on the list now. But from around all of North America, it's pretty impressive. But sign up on the registry to basically say, hey, killer robots, we will worship you. Please spare our lives.
So we should join this real quick?
I'm thinking it might be worth it.
It's a disappointingly well-made website.
It's very nice.
This guy is making tons of money off of a scare tactic. If people are actually
buying... How's he making money?
If people are actually buying his shirt. No, I saw he had stuff.
Well...
Jeremy Holt, you are going to pledge allegiance to killer robots on Men in a Tub on the Tubcast here.
Well, you know, if it happens, I want to be prepared.
Jeremy, what's your email?
Jeremy at men
in a tub dot com.
Inatub.com.
That's right.
Yeah.
You live in Iowa.
Yes.
I'm signing you up.
Thank you.
This is compelling stuff right here. You have.
Let's I'm going to be happened. Saved. You guys, not so lucky.
Hey, are we keeping him in the online scrappable registry?
Yeah.
Yes. Add to cart. Wait, you have to add it. You have to pay for it.
Wait.
This is a sham.
Oh yeah, we're going to find out what's happening here.
Wait, what is
we're not even reading through the pledge.
Is membership says, oh, view cart. Okay.
We need to.
$14.95.
Yeah. Well, if you want to be safe.
What scam is
if
this?
If you want to. No, this is not a scam. This
You're
is the
right,
real
because,
deal, folks.
Because it's not a golden ticket to heaven.
That's right. But if it was, you'd buy one.
So, wait, I want to know, how does this guy...
I like that the website is actually ipledgeallegiancetokillerrobots.com.
Yeah.
I want to know how this
guy
can... Well,
it'll make it easier for the killer robots to find him.
But how does he guarantee that his little slip of paper is going to be read by robots that are killers?
Because it's on the internet.
Okay.
So,
okay.
I say Men in the Tub should make our own pledge of allegiance to the killer robots.
Like as a group, like a committee.
Like we should like have a separate pledge.
If we have our own list, I mean, won't the killer robots? It's
they may find our list and find us more worthy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Has anybody seen the movie Ex Machina?
No,
but it looked good.
I really wanted.
Maybe
to.
It's oh
was
yeah,
that
goes
was
right
that certified
in line.
Fresh?
The trailer was really good, so I thought I should see.
Yeah, that was certified fresh, but that's actually very much. I mean, we're talking about AI. It's very much. Like it. I mean, there's a part in the movie where they talk about how eventually AI...
Are you giving any spoilers?
No. Okay. This is kind of like a conversation between two of the main characters, and they're like saying how like eventually AI will be so smart that it will replace humanity. And I was like, I never thought of that. Like, that's really creepy to think about.
How
like,
I don't understand how it becomes smart.
No, I guess... I mean, I've thought about it in like a Terminator way, but like never in a way that...
Never to that deepness?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of an interesting thought. I mean, if it gets to a point to where they're actually like, because it's about like kind of like androids or whatever. So like if they're actually like people and they can blend in with people and then they can deceive people and then eventually they
kill people. Yeah.
And then they have the intelligence to make more of themselves just like we do. So they can reproduce themselves. So then at some point there's just no more people. There's just robots. We like.
But global warming will kill them.
No. I'm just they'll figure, but they're smarter than that, right?
Yeah, yeah. So they'll just save the ozone layer.
Humanity gets the last laugh.
Take that, robot.
Hey, hey, we had this in plan for decades.
Can't beat us.
Yeah.
To be you.
The seeds of the robot empire's destruction were there at its birth.
Atomic bomb. Drop mic.
Yeah, but that's a terrifying thought, but I guess maybe it doesn't matter.
But if you're concerned, $14.95 could save your life.
I would just like to tack on to this. I went to the website myself and...
Signed up?
No. I stayed on the homepage longer than you guys did.
Sweet.
And it popped up after a while and it said, save yourself, sign up today. If you can't save yourself, save a friend. Share.
Nice. That's great.
It's a very nice website. So if you want to check that out, go to I Pledge Allegiance to Killer Robots.
If you got $15 to throw around, save yourself.
You know, let us know if you did.
Yeah.
We'll do you a favor. We'll add you for free to our list.
We should register Minitub on it, and then we can just hang
that'd be cool.
It'll cover all of us, right?
Yeah, we can just do a joint filing.
Can it be for all of our listeners too?
First name is Min In. Last name is A-tub.
A-tub.
Minin?
A-tub. Minin-a-tub.
Minin-a-tub.
We also do tech support on the weekends. Oh, that's a joke.
The best part is it's only funny to us.
Strongly resisting doing an accent right now.
That's very wise.
All right. So else we got?
So I thought that was pretty cool. And then I thought this. So you guys remember my toilet comment from last week? About
what was your toilet comment from last week?
So about my fear, my phobia of...
We thought you had an animal, but you never did.
Well, I'm proving to you
that you should be afraid.
That you should be afraid. I want not only the killer robots, but I want to save you guys from toilets and the animals that could come out of them. So
okay,
this is your safety section.
And in some way, I'm trying to validate myself and vindicate myself.
So this says, see how easily a rat can wiggle up your toilet. Sounds like a euphemism.
Yeah, and this is National Geographic, so you have to believe it.
Is this a potty safety announcement?
Look at that. Look at that rat.
Whoa, he's a good swimmer.
Good afternoon. You reach rodent control.
Washington, D.C.'s rodent control receives a couple of complaints each year.
You have a rat in your toilet?
You have a rat in your toilet?
How does this ultimate rat invasion actually occur?
It happens.
It looks like a turd, really.
That's
moving.
That's the fear.
It could easily sneak into grates or manhole covers open to the street.
Don't they live
residential
in the
sewer pipes feed into the main tunnel. A rat might consider this path an irresistible opportunity for exploration.
This is what rats listen to.
Like Mission Impossible.
Its sharp claws allow the rat to scale almost any vertical surface.
And it's aluminium steel bulge.
The rat is in the home's internal pipes. Going up, now it faces the biggest test. Getting through the last few feet of the narrow, maze-like toilet pipes.
And there's water in there,
is this even possible?
Yeah, they're going to tell you about that.
The underwater passage leaves no room for error.
Yeah.
At a turn, the rat finds a pocket of air.
Yeah.
Just enough to help it push on to the end of the line.
See, and there's air in there because that's the whole way the toilet works. Because once the amount of water is higher than the air pressure, it pushes the air out and the water goes down.
Yeah, so they find that little...
They found the pocket of air so they can breathe again. So, this fear is not
unfounded. Take a look at this rat's attempt to get to the other side of the tiny hole. If a rat can fit its head through an opening, the rest is easy because of its internal acrobatics.
Oh, it's just like...
When squeezing through a constricted space, the pressure causes the ribs to give way. At the spine, the ribs are hinged, allowing them to effortlessly collapse.
The sound effects.
Creepy.
I don't like rats anymore.
Or
how
toilets.
Does the rat deal with all that water?
It's kind of cute, though.
What if someone flushes?
So it bites your booty.
Can it swim?
Well,
now they have fun rat music.
We think of rats as land animals, but it turns out they're experts swimmers.
Oh, they're so cute.
So basically he's saying we can't flush that turd down the toilet.
No, because it'll swim and stay in the toilet bowl.
The tail also works as a kind of rudder.
They look funny when they swim.
Rats have incredible stamina. They can tread water for 3 days straight.
What? Are you kidding me?
And they can hold their breath underwater for up to 3 minutes.
What?
This aquatic proficiency is the very reason rats became global travelers.
Are we sure they're not otters?
Swimming enabled them to hitch rides on boats and
rats are close descendant to dolphins.
So yeah, I mean, rats.
That's not how that works.
That's crazy.
Totally is.
Tread water science. For 3 days?
So I don't know that I'll ever go to the bathroom without flipping the light on.
That's
anymore.
Right. Turn the light on. Look in the bowl before you go.
Well, you know, we should make an app for the iPhone that says like potty light, and it. I mean, I know you can already turn the light on easily, but it would just be like an app for you push the app and the light comes
and
on.
And we could have a little PSA announcement about the fear of rats.
Maybe
you would
turn
the
camera
bum.
On and have like a little crosshair on it, so you could aim it at the rat.
I like that.
Yeah, we're gonna.
No one steal our ideas.
Patent pending.
Well, yep. I am definitely replacing the light bulb in my bathroom when I get home.
Ratlight.
Yeah. Do it.
Ratlight.com.
There you go.
Wow.
So anyway, I thought you guys should know.
Now we know. Now we know toilet horrors are true. All of the horrors we could imagine about toilets and what could happen to our bum while we sit there.
Well, right. Just because what they do for an occupation, that doesn't make them toilets.
Okay. That is...
All righty.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. That was kind of like a drum roll. That was nice and build up to the thing.
Yeah, so that's about all I got.
Okay, cool.
That's it.
Hey, Trevor, what's up with spoilers and stuff?
I'm excited for the Star Wars movie.
Not.
I'm probably like the only person.
Spoiler alert! Trevor likes Star Wars.
Oh, man.
I didn't need to know that.
Yay.
Oh, you ruined it for him. What if the new Star Wars movie gets like a 8%?
It doesn't matter. I'll love it no matter what.
You'll love it no matter what because you're a slave to the brand.
The real question is, Eric, would you go see it if it got an 8%?
Ooh.
That's a good question. That's an excellent question.
We know Trevor's going to go regardless because he doesn't care about Rotten Tomatoes. But if it got an 8%,
would I go see it?
Would Eric Went go see that?
I would 100%. I would go see it.
I'm wondering if I should do like I did for the previous Star Wars and wait at least a decade or two before I see them.
It's probably a good idea.
I count it as a good sign that I still get goosebumps every time I still see that new trailer.
That was because I touched your leg.
That's true.
Were you in the toilet?
But I mean.
Yeah.
Anyhow, there's been a recent leak on the set, which are pretty rare. It seems they've been keeping a very tight lid on this and stuff. This
keep going back to the toilet.
Tight lid on that toilet.
The recent leak was actually of Luke Skywalker, and I think we're going to show it here. So if you're scared, look away now.
Yeah, don't look.
Especially if you're only listening to the podcast.
Yeah, don't look if you're listening.
Don't look if you're listening.
Let's give some details.
I will probably talk about it. So I mean, you should probably just ignore this completely.
Yeah, you should plug your ears.
But anyhow, it's interesting because I mean it. I don't know. He looks like a Jedi master. So I mean,
he is a Jedi master.
Well, it's really Batman.
He is technically a Jedi master, but it's interesting to see. It almost looks he doesn't look like a hermit that's been hiding away, at least to me.
That's because he has the Force.
To me, he looks like Obi-Wan.
he looks like he's wearing Ewan McGregor's costume from Episode 3.
Yeah, he does very look like kind of the old order. And so it almost looks like I'm thinking that there's going to be an established Jedi order in this, but I'm not sure. But I don't know. Seeing this kind of stuff excites me.
How exciting would that
so
be?
Just a question here. I know that there were a lot of people that before they threw out some of the novels as canon, they thought that Luke Skywalker was going to be a villain in this movie. Does this change your opinion of that?
Do you think
that Luke Skywalker is the hero in this movie?
Oh, I think he's the hero. I don't think he's a villain.
I think Han Solo is the hero.
Well,
that's true. That's honestly, the obvious.
Han Solo's the hero of every movie.
Yeah.
I think Han Solo is going to play a bigger part in this movie than Luke is.
I think, because he's on the cover. He's on the poster.
Is that big furry?
He also broke his leg or ankle, didn't he?
Did you just refer to Chewbacca as the big furry?
That guy.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. I'm going to slap you.
He's the big furry hamster man in this one.
Bigfoot, right?
Oh, man.
It's Bigfoot?
Technically.
You just shut up.
There was a non-canon comic where Han and Chewie crash landed on Earth and died, and Indiana Jones found them and thought Chewbacca was Bigfoot.
There you go.
This fan fiction?
No,
this
it's an officially licensed thing. You can look it up.
Nice. I want to read that.
If anyone has that, send it to iwantogetitmeninatub.com. We want to read it.
We would like to see it. Yeah.
I also heard that like Chris Pratt plays young Han Solo
in the Solo film.
Some flashbacks in this new movie. It's true.
Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed.
I don't think there's any flashbacks in the new
movie. Yes, there is.
Yeah, there's lots of flashbacks.
They are planning on making a flashback or a Han Solo movie where he's Han Solo. So.
All right. Well, then this brings up another question. Would you rather see Chris Pratt playing Indiana Jones or Han Solo?
I think he'd make a
Indiana Jones. That's one thing we need a comeback of.
See,
I think I would rather see him as Indiana Jones than Han Solo.
I don't think he could be partially, he wouldn't, I don't know. He couldn't really be a young Han Solo because he doesn't look anything like Han Solo would, really.
Really?
And honestly, he's a young guy, but he's not that young, though.
I don't know why you think that he wouldn't look like a young Han Solo, but he would look like a young Indiana Jones.
Well, okay, here's my deal. I don't picture him playing a young Indiana Jones. I would picture him more playing like a protege of Indiana Jones. You know, like he wouldn't be Indiana Jones. He would be,
the next
kind of taking up the lamp.
He could play Indiana Jones. Why wouldn't he be Indiana Jones?
Taking up the lamp?
So it'd be like...
The mantle.
The mantle.
That's what I'm looking for.
So it'd be like Ohioan John or something instead of Indiana
John. Oh my gosh.
I don't know.
The protege. You have to have a different state. Indiana's mine.
I don't know. I don't think it's that far of a shot.
Yeah, I think
a little bit of hair and makeup, you're
golden.
If he
grew his hair out a little bit and get clean shaven... Yeah, there's not that far of a difference there.
Just make a plot point of him getting that scar on his chin.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I just... my only thing is, Han Solo is not supposed to be very old there. I think he's supposed to be,
30 or so?
Maybe 30.
What is that? What's wrong with...
Chris Pratt just...
Oh, you're saying they couldn't do it before that because it'd be about the same age.
What?
What?
Well, Chris Pratt's in his 30s, so why?
Yeah, Chris Pratt doesn't look
young
enough.
He's got a baby face. If he was shaved.
He does have a baby face.
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Baby face.
I don't know.
Yeah, that is not a valid argument.
You can't just throw my argument out.
Yes, we can.
That he doesn't have a baby face?
He doesn't look young enough to be.
Yes, he does.
Yeah, I'm not sure how that's
an
argument.
Look at the one in the tie. Look how
smooth. Especially since he lost some of his Andy weight.
Yeah.
I guess. I don't know.
Let's see. Baby face. Look at that. There's a baby face.
I think he looks younger than Harrison Ford did in the Star Wars movies.
I don't know.
Harrison Ford has always looked old.
Has he?
Look at those eyes.
We could gaze into Pratt's eyes forever.
Look at the way he blinks. Look at that.
Blink for me, Chris. Oh!
There it is.
All right, and we've lost Eric.
You can believe it. It's happening.
I don't know who Chris Pratt is, and at this point, I'm too afraid to ask.
Oh, no.
Oh, really?
No, that was a joke.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, well, don't be afraid. This is a safe place.
That was a Chris Pratt line. So.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
It was a very meta joke.
That was very meta. I remember that episode of Parks and Rec. That's cool. Hey, JCard2000 says, what's up?
You.
Thanks.
Hey.
Thanks, J. Cord.
Hello.
I'm glad not just me is watching that.
Yeah.
What do you think about the show?
Yeah. Thanks for watching. Yeah. We appreciate your love and respect.
Which you should also give to the robots.
We were talking about bear problems a while back when this bear, he showed up in someone's. Oh, I totally skipped a story.
You totally
didn't
skipped someone.
I'm sorry.
Oh, Trevor, finish your story.
I'm sorry, Trevor.
I was paying attention to the comments.
He was stuck on Han Solo or something.
Yeah, I was gazing into Chris Pratt's eyes. it was hard for me. Dude. Someone did.
And it turned into bear love in some weird way.
I said it was hard for me to look away. Get it straight.
We need a bucket of ice over here.
Don't get it straight.
I think we need a goat.
All right.
Yeah, Chris Pratt's hot. No homo. That's right, J-Card.
Sesame Street.
There's a good transition.
So, anyways.
I'm not worried.
Sunny days. Chasing our blues away.
Can we get to Sesame Street?
So, this kind of broke this week, but Sesame Street.
It's about to get hard, is what you're saying.
Yep.
Because it's going to HBO.
Yeah. It's about to go crazy and all that.
Is it gonna become a reality show? That would be cool.
HBO hasn't ever done a reality show.
Seriously.
Except The Wire. That was a documentary.
Yeah, that was a documentary on Game of Thrones.
Did they do Entourage? Is that HBO?
Entourage.
I don't remember.
Yes, they did. But that is still not a documentary.
That still is not a documentary, nor is it Sesame Street.
No, but it's just totally bro-y.
Sesame Street.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Does this
Jeremy derailed the train because he said something about reality shows on HBO.
You suck!
Does this mean we're finally going to get to see Big Bird's chicken breasts?
Oh, gosh. Oh, boy.
Yes.
That gets you off there.
If that tickles your Elmo. Anyways, can you spit this story out already?
Right, so Sesame Street is doing stuff with HBO. They're going to be... Yeah, their episodes for the next 5 seasons, I think, are going to be shown on HBO like months before they're showed on PBS, which is their previous channel. But it's kind of an interesting move just because, you don't think HBO kids shows.
Yeah, they have like a weird Saturday morning thing that I've caught, and it's like kind of creepy and weird. Like, I don't even want my kids to watch it just because it makes me feel uncomfortable. But so this is a thing then. It's going to HBO, the home box office.
I find it interesting that they're like it seems like it's a good way for them to be able to make money for the whole Sesame Street workshop. I think they're going to spin a couple of new TV shows out of it too with the money they're making.
Yeah. See, when I first saw this, it made me think of it's funny because Sesame Street has actually done some pretty good like kind of parodies recently, and one of them that I saw was a House of Cards one, and they did like a thing where it was the Three Little Pigs or whatever. But
wait,
they had
Trevor watches Sesame Street. I'm sorry,
I saw a thing on YouTube.
Trevor subscribes to the Sesame Street YouTube channel.
In any case, I wouldn't be ashamed.
I mean, they were pretty out there with the whole Bert and Ernie thing. So
yeah, oh boy,
oh,
and gun rights. Sorry.
How many times are you going to derail this one?
He likes to bring up the
Burton. It's
just so easy. Yeah, it's just fodder for Jeremy to derail.
That's right.
Children's shows.
All right,
buddy.
So anyways, get your HBO subscription so your kids can watch Sesame Street, I guess.
Months ahead of all the people that don't have HBO.
The story.
I like how it's jumping from public broadcasting to the high-end cable stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I had. That was a really lame comment.
So, yep. Well, hey, it's irony, right? I guess. Yeah, it's free.
What about the bears, Eric?
Oh, yeah. So bears. Yeah, I just wanted to kind of. We talked about the bear that found the dog food a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, and then he fell asleep in the backyard.
He fell asleep in the yard, and bears are just, they're kind of on a roll because look at this guy.
He's so cute.
Yeah.
It's like a rat.
Yeah,
it's trying to squeeze through the hole.
Sticking his head through the cat door. It says,
see, cats are evil.
They let bears in.
Let bears into your house.
It's a known fact.
They're from space.
Yes, space
like,
cats.
That's like saying like a pastor's evil for letting a his door and then a murderer in.
True.
Well, that's true. It always is the pastor's fault. Black bear tries to enter man's home through cat door, says the headline here on Fox59.com. So this bear, look at his little snout, is looking for the picnic basket again. And I like that there's this picture of this cat sitting on the couch. She's like, yeah, there's a bear out there, so what? I can't be bothered right now.
I don't care.
But like then there's another picture, and there's like two, I don't know, the, a couple dogs out there and the, with the bear like, on the patio.
Hey, how's it going?
Just like, yeah, hey. It's another one of the boys.
Are you from around this part?
It sounds like they're kind of just letting this happen. They're just allowing the bear to hang out.
What are you going
to
do?
Bark? I don't know. You're a
dog.
Oh,
you mean the dogs.
Yeah. Rough. Like, do that. Like, try that.
They're just enabling.
Maybe they're smart and they realize how big the bear is.
Maybe the bear's their friend.
True.
Yeah, so it's one of those things. It says this is an Idaho man found quite a surprise. This is like the shortest story ever. It's like it's not even a whole paragraph. I think they just broke up the sentences. The door was heading into a condo. He had a cat door. Said last week the bear broke into his home, ate food, and defecated on his carpet.
Oh man!
not
again.
Just to add insult to injury.
Yeah.
I bet he blamed it on one of the dogs.
Yeah, that was big. That was a big steaming pile, though. I mean, have you seen a? Have you ever like heard of the bear plug? They like eat a bunch of roughage like
is that supposed to help stop
up their stomach when they go into hibernation?
Oh, yeah.
And then when they poop it out, like they pass it, it's like this massive, terrifying thing. So hopefully he didn't release his bear plug in this guy's. Done. Hey, JCard 2000 says, "What's your opinion on the Deadpool trailer?"
I'm intrigued.
It was
don't care.
I was kind of disappointed, honestly.
Really? You thought it sucked?
No, I
Trevor's not going to be seeing that movie.
See, for being like super
expect a 14% on Rotten Tomatoes.
For me, my opinion is for being like it was supposed to be like so edgy. It seemed just so
Edgy.
It seemed like very formulaically edgy,
very paint by numbers.
Yeah. So I don't know.
All right. Well, there you have it. That's our opinion on Deadpool.
I
don't see
what's
it.
What's your opinion on Deadpool?
Yeah, J-Card, what's your opinion? Are we wrong? We're probably wrong. But, yeah. I mean, you know.
Fight about it?
Yeah, we could fight about it. You can fight Nathan. So yeah. Batman died, guys. This is a sad story. Yeah.
Did Deadpool kill
him? This is the real Batman. He's known as Route 29 Batman. He was killed after his Batmobile broke down in Maryland.
Now, is that a Ferrari?
It's a Lamborghini.
Lambo. They're the same.
This guy, this is an interesting story. I like that he chose the 1990s Batman costume. I think that was a good decision.
Yeah, I like it.
A nod to Michael Keaton. Let's look at the photos real quick here. Let's see if there's anything worth looking at. Oh, I like when it breaks the webpage. That's cool. There's no photos.
Yes.
So this guy, he was made famous in like, I think it was like 2012. There was a viral video that was going around of.
Oh, I remember seeing this.
Police pulling over. Pulling over Batman, which the internet is totally broken to.
You probably have the other video playing.
So anyways, these cops pull him over in his Lambo, and they were actually really courteous. They didn't tase him or anything. That was nice.
Well, it was how many years ago?
Because he's Batman.
It's 2012. It's not that long ago.
Well.
But anyways.
Hands up.
He made a lot of money in his business, and he used his fortune to buy this car and dress up as Batman and go to hospitals and like visit kids. And you know, the people that knew him said that when he like after he did it, he donned the suit, it like brought a lot of cheer to these kids, and it's almost like he felt like he kind of found his purpose in life, which I mean it's one of those things where you would think maybe this guy might have like a mental problem or something, because he's dressing as Batman and he's driving in a car and he's spending hours putting on black eye makeup and all and getting a suit on and like sweating in this hot suit. But it's one of those things that is a heartwarming story, but it's also sad because I guess he was getting gas at a gas station. So people saw him, he waved, he said hi. And then he drives off and he is having engine trouble, which is also kind of concerning because it looked like a fairly new Lamborghini, but I guess he'd been driving it for a while, so it's at least 2000.
Well, I'm thinking he just passed the mantle. Here's why.
Yeah, but then he let me finish.
Okay,
here.
Go ahead. Go for it.
Before you jump the shark. His engine had problems, whatever. He gets out to look at it and he was kind of in the middle, almost on the fast lane a little bit, and some Toyota Corolla or something like rear-ended his car and shoved the car over him. He passed away. It's a sad story, but it was
terrible.
Kind of one of those things that you wonder why that would happen to someone that was bringing such cheer and joy to children. And without further ado, Jeremy wants to bring this story into the political realm.
Well, we kind of have a thing going with Donald Trump, and this story just brings him back into the limelight, I guess, because he was in Iowa at the state fair this weekend, and he tells everybody that he's Batman. Donald Trump says, "I'm Batman."
Nailed it.
So there you go. We have a new Batman, folks.
All right. I'm glad that we know that because it was a concern of mine of knowing who was going to replace Batman.
Hey, well, here's the best part about that story with Trump is that the guy that voices Batman on the animated
show got
really upset and made sure that the world knew it.
Really?
So yeah, he said that he was the Batman.
Oh, that's funny.
Nice.
So
was he like, "I'm Batman"?
In your headlines for disturbing new trends, this is coming to us from mirror.co.uk.
Oh, boy.
Police probe sick online craze where social media users take selfies with dead bodies for cash.
How much money?
I love that that's your first question.
Selfie with a deceased awards prizes for the best picture with a corpse. 50 euros.
It's a competition.
50 euros.
I thought it was like for every British dead body.
Our pounds, 50 pounds. Sorry, I don't know my number signs. My currency. Sorry, I'm not up to.
That's still a number sign.
No, you're fine.
So, anyways, they recently offered it for a pic. With a body of a 13-year-old girl killed in a car crash.
Okay, that's a little far. That's terrible.
So people. I read through this article and all I could think, like, you can see these pictures,
man,
of people like at funeral homes with like their dead grandma in the casket.
Want to make 50 bucks?
Rest in peace, Granny. Honestly, couldn't have asked for a better grandma. Something. I don't know, but I'm gonna take
a duck
lip selfie with you. Yeah, there's a double selfie there. I mean, it's pretty disturbing.
That's creepy.
But I think it speaks volumes to our like wannabe celebrity culture where like people are so willing to do anything for attention. Like it's like as long as I'm getting approval from somebody, it doesn't matter who it is. As long as somebody what reason is giving me attention, I'm going to do this thing, and I'm going to smile in front of this dead body.
By the way, give us some attention. I want to get it minutetup.com.
What?
People wanting attention on the internet.
He's implying we're hypocrites.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks. Jeremy's just trying to steal thunder, as he always does.
Yeah, that's true. We haven't started posing with dead bodies, so I think if that time came, we would hopefully pull the plug.
The tub?
Anyways.
The drain.
Yeah. But I don't know. I just, the fact that this is going on, hopefully I didn't. Maybe I brought attention to it to all five people that are watching us right now. They're going to start doing
this.
We're
up to five?
Yeah, we were. Oh, we dropped to four.
Someone's
playing too soon.
Sorry.
Disagree with you. I'm right. Out.
Oh yeah, they were one of these people in this picture.
that's my granny.
That's how I make my living.
Yeah,
I was
instead of wedding crashers, there's funeral crashers.
When you started this story, Eric, I was going to compare it to an old tradition from like back when photography was still new, to commemorate a passed on loved one by taking pictures with them as if they were still alive. But this is completely different because this is just whoring out the dead person.
Yeah,
for cash.
It's terrible.
It's pretty bad.
Granny didn't give me no inheritance. I'm getting 50 bucks.
Let's go to something else here that's a little less sad, but still involving death. I found this article about a game that's coming out here soon. It's going to be a PC game, so Trevor and Eric can get in on this if they like. A game called The Flock, and it's going to be... It says that it might be the first video game with built-in obsolescence. Did I say that right?
Obsolescence.
Yeah. Sometimes I can't read. So anyway, they basically are putting a cap number on how many deaths can happen in the game before the game shuts down.
So you buy this game, and then there's like potentially you won't ever get to play the game again.
Well, no, it's not that. So they said that they're going to put in enough of a counter that it's not going to die within like days or something. But then they said, you know, we don't know exactly how long the game will go. Because it's going to be based on online, the online death toll.
How many deaths?
I think it said 215 billion.
Holy cow!
So I think
but that's in-game deaths.
In-game deaths.
People can die repeatedly.
So I think there will probably be a whole group of people who are like, "Hey, let's see how quickly we can keep dying and rank up our deaths."
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
That's like maybe. Or maybe you want to try and see how long you can keep the game going. But the game creators have said that by their own estimations, the game will probably last for about a year. That's what their estimations are. They don't have any plans to add more numbers at any time unless it gets delivered out to like PlayStation and Xbox.
All it takes is one in-game death cult to lower that. Estimate by a lot.
Yeah, I know. Everybody just starts.
I really want
Jeremy's
going
to buy a PC just to troll people.
I'm seriously thinking about doing that. I mean, they put themselves in a position for people like me to be like, I'm gonna make this. No, I'm fulfilling the game.
You know,
but they made that a goal. That's how you win.
I liked what it said in this Verge article because it said, if nothing else, the scheme feels like a clever way to get around the biggest problem with multiplayer focused games. Few of them last for very long. So, I mean, you know, there's all kinds of online games that don't ever have a lot of shelf life or conclusion. So it's like it gives you a specific thing that it's like, oh, we've got to play this while we can play it until it's gone. I think it's kind of a neat idea
It's already been an idea. Kojima... He had this idea for a video game years ago. I think it was around the time of the PlayStation that he wanted to make a game. Obviously, Konami wouldn't get on board, but he wanted to make a game that when you died, for all intents and purposes, the disc would self-destruct somehow.
That'd be
Mission Impossible.
And your $60, $50 whatever game is just rendered useless once you die.
I would never buy that game because I would be so too mad.
Yeah.
Yeah, but hey, I mean, think about it though. If you could actually beat the game, like, yeah, that's I mean,
street cred.
Maybe that's street cred.
That would be some street cred.
That actually would be a real achievement.
How many times did you have to buy the game to win?
I just started using mods.
Yeah, I know.
Now, how funny would that be if they made that game and then it's like, it's not very long at all. It's like a 5-minute game, but there's somebody that kills almost everyone like a minute into it.
Oh gosh,
that would be funny.
I'm already scheming on how to do that.
All right. Well, there you go. Jeremy's got a new scheme.
Get on board.
Another story that I found had to do with another bear. This seems like this is a theme this week.
Marsupial.
This one had to do with a koala bear that chased down an Australian farmer. And this lady was kind of disturbed as this koala came running after her. And I don't know if you've seen like the claws on them. They're cute and cuddly when they're just hanging on a tree. But when they're chasing after you, that's terrifying.
That koala can move.
Yeah.
They're like on an ATV.
Yeah, she's
or something.
On an ATV. She's herding her cattle. And this koala bear, as you do when you're an Australian farmer, and this koala bear is chasing her.
Get away!
Get away!
He's like,
I just want a ride.
She jumps off the side and doesn't know where it is.
Oh my god, it's on the freaking bike.
And it's like hanging on the tire.
Mommy.
And they're saying that...
I don't know what I'm going to do now.
It is something that's happened, that it might be confusing the sound, This was some university's...
some smarty pants
some
theory.
Some smarty pants theory that they believed that the koala might have been confusing the sound of the bike with that of a koala mate.
Because it was purring.
The male do not touch the tailpipe, buddy.
Well, but then male don't koalas frequently bellow in response to airplanes, wow. tractors, chainsaws, etc. So they're saying it may be that they confuse the noises as bellows by other koalas, which could be why that koala was just hanging on the side of that tire like that. I don't know. Maybe it was looking for another koala to do a horizontal polka.
It's obviously blind.
Hey, Supercat 121. Hi.
Hi.
They said hi. We were just saying hey. Hi to you. Hi, how's it going?
Hello.
So yeah, this koala was just, you know, it was that sultry, purry, warm ATV sound was just drawing it in, you know? Just
all right. Yeah.
That just happens.
It just sucks them in. So one other story that I had here, there was a dump truck that forgot to pull its pants up. As it was driving down the highway.
Yeah, yeah because... Yeah.
Sure.
I like the look on your face, Nathan.
Pants.
So, I don't know if this was something that was on purpose or not, but this truck is driving down the highway with... The dump truck part is up like it had just dumped everything out of it, and it takes out... a highway sign, like a sign that's hanging over.
Look at the truck that's right there. Like, look at the white truck.
Oh my God!
And someone's gonna hear from their supervisor.
The best part is somehow the truck doesn't tip over.
Yeah,
Hey guys, can you pick up this trash you just made?
That is impressive.
Oh, well, it was such a nice crumble too. It was like Hollywood-esque almost.
Yeah.
It was a pretty clean getaway there for the sign. They were lucky that no one else
and
was
the
very
truck.
Close.
Nobody was like underneath it or something.
That, yeah. That is impressive.
Let's watch it one more time. I like how it just takes out the entire
yeah.
sign. It's just like peace, taking you all out.
Well, the
it would have been better if he drove away.
Kind of hanging there.
Yeah, that's true.
It was impressive. Wow. So it made me laugh when I saw that. I figured I.
Oh, sign of the times.
Buns. Ooh, you suck.
Yep. Every week.
So mean, poor Nathan.
We Stop love you, Nathan. It. You're our special guest.
I'm the special guest.
Oh, speaking of Nathan.
Oh, so Eric.
Yeah.
You were talking about the bear problems going on.
Yeah. Oh,
one man is taking it upon himself to take care of this.
That's fantastic.
That's how I'm spinning it anyway.
Okay, great.
Batman?
Oh, no, boy. No.
Bear Man.
So, in this, I think it's a state park.
Can we read the headline real quick?
Yes, please.
Man in bear costume harasses bears near Haines. This is Alaska. Dispatch News. Yeah, coming from ADN.com.
So, up in Alaska, there's been this mama bear and her two cubs who have come to this stream consistently for a while.
Sure.
One day, this guy puts on a fairly realistic-looking bear suit, comes up and just starts growling at them until they go away.
There's so many levels to this.
There's so many other directions this could have gone. It could have been a koala story all over again.
Wait,
So the state troopers took him aside... and told him not to do that. He refused to give them a name. He got into his car wearing the bear hat. So they...
Thug life.
So that is definitely him.
So they never saw his face, but they did get his license plate information as he sped off on the highway still wearing the suit.
Hey, bear.
They didn't
this
chase
is my
after
river.
Him?
Get out of here.
Apparently not.
I'm going to say that's a brave soul to approach a bear and its two cubs and just be like, get off my land.
Well, especially a mama bear. I mean, that's like your stereotypical thing you don't approach.
Hey, it's a brave bear man. Guy, I've got this golden ticket I'd like to sell you.
I think one of the best parts of the story is there's a quote from one of the park administrators where they say, this isn't the first time we've had something like this happen.
Really?
How is like what?
That's I don't know. I
think we've got our show's picture.
We want to know.
It's mental illness, I think.
I mean, would any of you dress up as a bear and approach a bear?
Heavens no. Jeez.
I don't think I'd even do it at like a zoo. I'd feel weird about that.
How
like,
much money's in it?
I would do it at a zoo because it's totally controlled environment. As long as I didn't go in a cage.
I could handle looking like a moron, although only being mauled by a bear would be a bit different.
Yeah. Oh, well, anyways, at least, you know, the bear thing, it just keeps on going. Yeah. Well, hopefully we continue it into next week.
Go Bears.
We'll have to see.
Go Bears. So 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, I think it might have been.
2 weeks ago, we talked about the Chinese escalator incidents.
Uh-huh.
Incidents.
Yeah, they were bad.
They were brutal. This week, the reaction is kind of hilarious. There's really not a lot to this story. It's just pictures, but these are the measures people are taking to avoid dying on escalators.
Just walk up the stairs. Straddle the escalator.
I like the lady approach. You know, you're wearing a dress, you side saddle that escalator. That is impressive. This isn't actually a video. What is this? Oh, okay. It's how you put panties on. This is
one leg in front of the other.
That's what ads are for.
Man, that is
blanket. Blanket.
Yeah.
Oh.
Blanket. It's called the plankulator. Sorry. This technique.
This is the best. Danger area.
Just jump over it. It looks.
I can see them like getting these as stickers and putting them on the sides of the escalator.
It looks like an Olympic diver, jumping off
such
of the
nice form.
Escalator. Yeah. That third one, like in the middle where his back is arched and his arms are up. And it's just like, oh.
You just want him to lick.
I give him a 9.
This woman is testing it with an umbrella before she walks.
That's nice.
Because the umbrella would let you know.
Because the lady who just went.
Oh,
in front
man,
of
this
her
guy
did.
Is like got a baby and he's trying to stop his son from getting his legs ripped off. I feel
that's
kind of
a
bad
brave
for
dad.
Him.
He's like, I'm gonna jump in here first with the baby. You stay back.
Gosh. I didn't know it was so pervasive that this was like such a problem. Like,
well, I mean, I would probably be doing the same thing if I was in China.
Do you think it's population based? Like, it's like an odds game, like because there are more people there. That like this probably happens just as frequently in America.
But
we
that
just
would mean
don't
there
have
to be maybe there's more escalators.
Well, I know,
there,
but there's more people, so there's more escalators.
Right. I don't know. I mean, I think if there were three different issues that happened in close
week.
Proximity in 1 week, I'd be.
But maybe that's a normal week in China, you know?
I think
maybe.
It's probably safety standards.
Maybe they just don't have a good escalator inspector.
Yeah. Yeah. I think America's got like higher safety standards for like equipment.
They can't repurpose grinders in America for
don't
escalators.
Quote me on that, but I mean
our stuff's kind of made in Japan, not China.
Meat grinders.
Oh, so well, there we go. We got that.
There you go. Now you know how to go up an escalator. Someone wants to do that. Send us a video. We'd like see how
if
you do
if
it.
You try to plank it, we really want a video of that. Yeah. We want to share it with the world. So
please don't hurt yourself.
Don't
in the
hurt
making
yourself.
Of a video. Though.
Yeah. Don't lose any
this
limbs.
Is
we will not
safe.
Accept any responsibility for this.
No. Mm-hmm. We may take we a picture with you, but that's only because we want 50.
50 pounds.
Oh, no.
Okay.
If anyone of us would do that, it would be Jeremy.
Moving on.
So.
Yeah. Need a selfie stick for that.
I only just found this one today, but there was a child who was born with both male and female parts.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And for reasons that the article doesn't state, was a ward of the state. So around the age of 3, I believe it was, the state had the male parts surgically removed and decided that the child was female.
They picked for the child.
Right.
Ooh.
So when
well,
the child...
parents have the right to do that in these scenarios. So...
But so when the child was adopted...
That's how you handle Jeremy professionally.
So when the child was adopted, after a while... she started identifying as male, and the adoptive parents figured out, oh, this is what happened, yada, yada. And so they are now suing the state and the hospital.
Hmm. So they have to do a surgery again?
You hear that, Bruce? Own it.
The article does not specify what measures are being taken in terms of the physicality.
Yeah. Okay.
Man, that's
crazy. That would be rough, though. You know?
It's a tough situation, yeah.
I don't know how to take that one.
That seems like it would be hard enough as a parent, let alone just the state being able to just make a decision. Oh, we'll just do this one. Just do it like that, and we'll be good.
Like flip a coin.
You'd think
something.
The state, with all the red tape, they would have just done nothing.
Yeah.
Really? I mean,
yeah. Well, in a situation like that, typically, it is far easier just to cut the parts off. I mean,
that's, all of them. Yeah,
so you're saying cut the all easier of the parts surgery off. Is to become a lady.
In this situation, yes.
Maybe so. Maybe. I don't know. I'm not a doctor, so I can't really comment.
I'm not a doctor, you dingus.
Any doctors out there on the interwebs watching this, let us know.
Send it to iwantogetatmeninatub.com.
Yeah, thank you.
If you can't tell, we want to read your mail.
Whether that be male or female.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Boo.
That's where I jumped the shark. So.
Yeah.
There was a study released the other day. Which said soft drinks are not one of the leading causes of obesity in America.
That's surprising.
Oh, really?
And the best part is that this study was funded by Coca-Cola.
Convenient.
Well, they only tested regular Coke and not diet.
Right.
Or was it new Diet Coke?
I wonder what how many factors or how many asterisks.
They probably asked how many people were drinking new Coke, and since none of them were drinking new Coke, it wasn't a problem. They weren't. Yeah. That wasn't the reason.
Right.
Well, it doesn't do anything.
New Coke, yeah.
Is it just me, or does that sound like something that would be in the Fallout series, new Coke?
Yeah. Nuke.
Yeah, you can see that, yeah.
Well, the best part is in the disclosure of the whole deal. It says that there's this media group and an unrestricted gift from the Coca-Cola company.
I like it.
Subtle.
I like it.
Hey, guys, we'll just keep throwing money at you until you give us the right answer.
See, I'm trying to decide if it would be it'd be good to do like the research for companies, or if it'd be really annoying. Because you'd have to find like creative ways to make
someone
it say
over
the
your
right
shoulder
thing.
Just like, so how much weight did our subjects gain? And just be like, okay, well, that's really not the answer we're looking for. Yeah. Let's do that again. This time, use Coke Zero.
Hey, you fatties!
And don't feed them anything else. Yeah. Just the Coke.
Yeah, study proves humans can live off Coke alone.
Ding. All right, one more and then I'll be done.
Okay,
what do we got?
Okay, so you guys have seen The Goonies, right?
I love that movie. Nope. It is one of my
really
favorite
Trevor,
movies.
I need to fix that.
Hey,
Trevor!
Guys!
Has Trevor not seen Goonies?
Trevor just said Goonies. That.
Trevor, did you not see it because the trailer didn't suck you in?
Yeah.
Yes.
And it was
the trailer,
released in the
80s. Which definitely played before I was alive.
Doesn't matter. You could have seen it.
Classic.
Goonies is such a good movie. It's probably my top two.
It's one I've always wanted to see.
I've heard it. I mean, some people I've heard, they were like, well, if you've never seen it and then you see it as an adult, that they're like, it didn't really hold up. But I don't know.
I didn't see it until like last year and I still liked it.
Oh, did you? Okay, yeah. Good.
I thought it held up.
Proven wrong.
But did you tweet about it while watching it?
Not yet.
Not yet. Do that soon. So anyways, Goonies,
so,
right?
So, Goonies. the house where the main character and family live.
Mm-hmm.
It is currently privately
Trevor,
owned.
Stop yawning.
I'm sorry.
Wake up.
I'm bored. I don't know what the movie's about.
Oh, man. I know it's about a movie you've never seen.
I can't stop. I keep yawning.
It's about a house, Trevor. You should be interested.
Yeah.
It's not that I'm
it's a
not
homeowner.
Interested.
Landowner Calrissian.
Yeah.
I'm glad that caught on.
That's good.
So,
the Goonies, their house.
There's this woman who lives there now. She sank so much of her money into it, refurbishing it, getting it, you know, to the state it's in currently. And for years, the city has been encouraging tourism by saying, oh, we have the house from the Goonies.
So people
will just come up to her lawn and take pictures and admire it. And she goes, that's all well and good. It's the people who leave beer bottles, cigarette butts, let their dogs poop in my yard, and do the truffle shuffle in front of my house that annoy me. So she has
you're laughing. You've never seen the truffle shuffle.
Who wants to do the truffle
I'm
shuffle?
I'm aware it's some sort so of
Nathan's
going to
do it.
Nathan's going to do it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there it is. Yeah. Oh, stop it.
So she no, has seriously. Put up a sign saying access denied to the Goonies house. Thank you for your interest. And one of the city councilmen said, I'm surprised she didn't do this years ago.
Nice.
We've just been sending people up there. We thought she liked it.
The real question is, who did the truffle shuffle that finally broke the camel's back?
That's the real question.
That's the question. I want to know who that person is, and I want to see the video.
If you're watching, send it to iwantogetitmeninatop.com.
She's like, I got tired of telling the women they couldn't do it.
This could be great. If we get a bunch of people to send us videos of them doing the truffle shuffle, that could be a thing.
That would be fantastic.
Put together a compilation video.
Right.
Have it on our
That's right. You want to be
All right,
famous?
Guys, you know what time it is?
Yeah.
It's time for advice in 60 seconds. This is the part of the show where a different tubber every week tries to answer as many Yahoo questions as possible in 60 seconds with only yes or no answers and one wild card. Tonight's contestant, Jeremy! Woo! Yeah!
I'm so excited!
All right. So... we need someone to keep score since Jeremy's our normal scorekeeper.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I'll do it.
Okay, I need to bring up the timer. I forgot the timer.
Timer. We need the timer ready.
I'm sorry. 60-second timer.
Google. Don't look at my screen.
Is our friend. Alphabet is our friend.
So if you couldn't hear me over the sound of our music.
Reset.
Which I'm sure you could, but I'm going to give Eric
win?
The time.
All right.
You don't win anything. So.
Oh, it's still playing.
60 seconds.
Theme music won't stop. Okay.
60 seconds right. to Are answer you ready? As many Yahoo Answer questions with yes or no. And one that is a wild card.
You get a wild card.
Anything I want.
You can say anything.
Okay. We had the record broken last week with 15.
Yeah, I'm the winner in the house.
Eric is the high score holder.
Mm-hmm.
Can it be broken tonight?
I want to know the entire question. I'm ready.
You want to know the entire question?
What does that
question?
Even mean? I'm not sure what
not
that
just
means.
The highlights, man.
Oh, okay.
He's going to have the lowest score.
Okay. All right, ready?
Did you mute the timer?
No.
Are you ready?
Yes.
See, I was on practicing. I said no, and that's one of the answers.
Get set. Go.
There's a family member who seems to have a problem with her sister. She withdraws from conversation when the other person speaks?
Yes.
Why doesn't my family care about me anymore?
No.
How can I transmit video from my PS3 to my TV upstairs?
Yes.
How do I not get scared of monsters at night?
Don't look in the toilet.
Politics, when was Wisconsin taken over by the Nazi party?
No.
Sending messages, but still am not on password?
Yes.
How might the wind turbines affect the climate?
No.
How can I pay to go away for college?
Yes.
What would you do if you worked in a child care center and you observed bruising on a child's body while changing their nappy?
Yes.
Parents, would you trust a male babysitter?
No.
What would you do if it was me, Radmaden?
No.
Attend the wedding when there was a consensus that I came aloof.
Yes.
I'm 30 weeks prego and freaked out now?
Yes.
Movie about revenge.
No.
Oh, done.
Oh, that was tough. Some of those were real yes or no answers.
Yeah, I don't know. What's the score, Nathan?
I didn't format this correctly, so I'm
He's tallying.
Tallying the score.
One of those I did not get through the question.
I don't know what you said. You kind of spit it out all of the rest.
Yeah. It was supposed to be attended a wedding and there was a consensus that I came off aloof.
Okay, you got it?
It is 14.
Oh, so close. Man. Sorry, Jeremy. Maybe next time.
Next time.
Next week, we'll return with more answers in 60 seconds.
Everyone's a winner.
It's advice in 60 seconds.
It's not advice, it's answers.
Advice is the name of the segment, though.
It is? I thought it was answers.
We should debate this more. I'm sorry.
Okay. We probably should.
It should maybe be answers in 60 seconds, but we're giving advice.
We are giving advice. We're giving a lot of advice. I stand corrected. It is advice in 60
I'm
seconds.
I'm sorry.
Do we get
it's the cold. It's the cold, you
It's
know?
The cold. I'm off my game.
You know, it's kind of funny because what's the acronym of that? Because you don't include you don't include prepositions.
Say what?
I don't know. The grammar Nazis are striking again.
I'm so
it's
confused.
ASS is what he's saying.
Oh.
Advice in 60 seconds. Oh. Oh, that's a good. That's,
that was not important.
That's a good
acronym.
Maybe
we should start spelling it with the number 60.
Yeah. I think that's a good idea, probably.
Yeah.
Leave all the other ones on the backlog the way they are.
Do I get a participation award, though?
You know.
You do. You've got the second highest score, Jeremy.
Sweet.
You know what time it is now? It's time for emails.
Emails!
We have some!
We have one, at least. Christina sent us an email, and it's directed to Jeremy. It says, Jeremy.
Hi, Christina. How you doing?
Did you...
That was creepy, wasn't it?
That was extremely creepy.
Yeah, that was creepy.
Well, hey!
Anyway,
if you want a creepy email, send it to Jeremy.
Jeremy will talk to you creepily if you email him.
At iwantogetitmeninatub.com.
Be sure you specify that it's for Jeremy.
Yeah. Send him pictures.
of the truffle shuffle.
The truffle shuffle. Jeremy says... No, Jeremy doesn't say this. Christina says to Jeremy, did you happen to watch Ghoulies as a child? This is where I find my fear of something being in the toilet stems from. Now, as you
can
included
we pull
a
up
picture.
Yeah,
let's see this picture of it. And that's Ghoulies. I've never seen this movie.
Me either.
We talked about the toilet fear last week.
And now this week as well. Yeah.
The rats. So you've never seen this movie?
Can we play the trailer?
Let's see.
I thought we didn't do trailers.
Oh, we can find. Let's see if
it's on there.
It's Ghoulies trailer.
Nope. Scroll down.
Sorry.
It's right there.
There.
Well,
it is.
We're looking for it. I just went and checked it out, and I want to know. Let's watch this and see if Trevor wants to watch this movie.
What do you guys want to do?
Well, we could play hide and go seek.
Yeah.
I can already tell you no.
Yeah.
Yeah!
Strip poker.
Yeah.
Strip poker.
Yeah.
Let's do a ritual.
Yeah, oh, I'm pretty sure I was not allowed to watch this as a child.
They're gonna do a ritual.
Bow here.
Wait.
Yod he bow here.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself.
Hey, knock it off!
Come. I order thee.
Getting scared.
I like that guy's sunglasses.
That's not a pentagram.
Well, that was fun.
No, wait. I need to dismiss the spirit.
So do I. Where's the bathroom?
They're ruining so many of the punchlines.
There will be 80s. Some surprise guests.
Oh, man. That dude looked like a rat.
They have very bad manners. And they have no respect for privacy. They'll wake up.
Brought to you by Jim Henson's cousin.
And they never take no for an answer.
Oh, man, that chick is really a screamer.
These puppets are terrible.
Once they show up, you can never get rid of them.
Watch out for the piano.
Definitely weird. And I kind of want to watch it now.
Yeah. Oh, there it is.
There it
out
is.
Of the toilet. The
oh, well, that was great.
Well,
I don't recall being allowed to see such things as a child.
You were too busy.
But I think if we can find that on Hulu or Netflix.
I think it is on Netflix.
We should have a viewing. We should live stream us watching that.
Yeah.
I think that's a great idea.
That sounds like a...
Men in a Tub
like
Theater.
Trevor House Party.
3,000.
Men in a Tub Theater 3,000.
Ooh, yes. That's a great idea.
All right. If for anyone that was curious...
Anyway, thank you, Christina.
It's got a zero on Rotten Tomatoes.
Trevor would not have approved of this.
How many critic ratings is that?
But it probably doesn't have any.
It's probably like one.
It's nine reviews.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. So
21% of audiences liked it.
Wow. 0%.
Yeah. Jeez. But it's only 9 reviews, so.
Yeah, that's it.
Only.
So, Jeremy, is that where it came from? It's probably not. No, probably not.
But are you
going to be able to go poop again?
I think after watching the movie, maybe not.
I mean, just even seeing that picture. That is
creepy.
That's really creepy.
That is really creepy. I mean, how creepy can it get and stuff?
That creepy.
can get very creepy. I think that's our only email. I think that's it for this evening. I appreciate
and we're working on
All of your attention.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for all the people who were in chat today,
watching us on Twitch
live. Appreciate that,
especially that guy that asked us about Deadpool. I appreciated that.
Yeah. Thanks. Yeah. Thanks for helping us out. It's been a lot of fun. We'll see you next week, maybe.
Yeah, why not?
We appreciate your listenership. Share your friends if you like this. If you like what we do,
check these guys out.
Share it with your friends and say, "Listen to this podcast. It's redonkulous."
Redonkulous.
That would have been better that week we had the donkey.
Yeah, yeah.
That would have been.
Maybe there'll be a goat next week. Who knows?
With a head for a hand.
So. But no bears.
No bears.
But thanks. Peace out, listeners. Men in a Tub Nation.
I like it. It stands.